My name is Dr. Ezekiel Okowa. I'm here to present a course on ECN 215, which is Principles of Finance. This is our study session 3. We have done others earlier. And today the main topic is sources of business capital. Business capital. We know that in every business, capital is needed. And we have different types of businesses, and we have different levels of capital that is that will be needed to effect such business. And also, in the process, we'll try to find out what is capital. We say sources of business capital. What is real capital? These are funds raised to support a particular business or project. It also has to do with the factor of production, because the capital, land, labor, all capital for production. It also could be financial assets such as funds held in deposit accounts. It also could be financial value of assets such as tangible machinery or production equipment. So I also have two categories of capital. They include physical capital and natural capital. Natural capital has to do with manufactured capital, such as capital produced by human labor used for production. Human labor used for production, such as machinery or building. And we also have natural capital, which has to do with natural resources. That is could be such as land, sea, ocean, forest, timber, solid minerals. All these are natural resources. And there are ways of getting them converted so that they can now be refined to meet the present-day needs. Another one is fundamental capital, products that will enhance a person's economic power or use the usefulness of an individual. And when you have roads, roads are to facilitate human movement and mobility from one city to another in order to enhance its production. And we'll talk about costs of capital. Before capital is acquired, there's costs for it. In elementary form, we'll look at if you want to go for particular funds, maybe from the bank, how much, what is the interest that you're going to pay? And if you're investing in a company as a shareholder, the cost of the capital is that amount that should be paid to you at the end of every production period. So we say that is amount, the cost of capital is amount paid to acquire capital, or a weighted average of the returns that investors expect from various debt and equity security issued by issued. And this definition has been extended by Richard et al. And we also see that this capital we are talking about, for both the debt, you know, when there's money borrowed from the bank, the cost of it is interest. While when it is vested as a shareholder in a company, then the dividend is the cost too. We see also that the cost of capital has to do with when it is debt capital, interest rate to be paid by the firm to borrow funds, and also when it's equity, we'll talk about returns or dividend to be paid to investors. Then big firms can access this capital, unlike the small and medium enterprises. That's why sometimes the government will come in to assist the small and medium enterprises. Why the big firms, the conglomerates, the international multinational companies can easily access whatever level of funds they need from the banks, but it is not so with the small and medium enterprises. That's where the government comes in. Capital structure. We look at capital structure as part of capital that is obtained through debt or equity. When a company will be able to look at the structure of its capital to see whether it should take more of debt or more of equity. Because when it is equity, we know that the company will not be stampeded to return the money. But when it is debt, the company is always restive. It's always looking at ways of making sure it doesn't default for on the debt of repayment. So the company or the establishment will be able to look at this capital structure, whether to take more of debt or more of equity. We'll talk about trade-offs involved. Debt capital increases the risk, which affects firms' earnings. which affect firms' earnings. And also look at the part of the capital structure is that it decreases the firm's stock prices, and also that leads to a higher return, increases a firm's stock price. That leads to a higher return. And as explained by Graham, he said the optimal capital structure is the one that strikes a balance between risk and return, thereby maximizes the price of the stock and simultaneously minimizes the costs of capital. And in general, companies tend to have stable sales levels, assets that make collateral for loans and a high growth rate can use debt more heavily than other companies. And also we see on the other hand, companies that have conservative management, high profitability or poor credit ratings may wish to rely on equity capital instead. So we look at, that is the issue of capital structure. I've said that the company must be interested on how to combine its capital base, its capital, in order to maximize profit, because the shareholders are waiting to get their dividend while the debt, where the bank where the money was collected as loan, will also be waiting to receive its money paid back. Most times we discover that some loans have gone bad because of lack of addressing such loans as at when due. Okay, we'll look at sources of business capital categorized into two. Debt sources are divided into two, which are private sources. Private sources, how an individual can get his capital, which include friends and relatives, we said that, and could be assisted. Banks could also come in. Credit unions, there are some organizations that run some of these issues, some of these ideas that an individual can go to some of those unions and collect some loan. Those loans are not the type that must be assessed by the big conglomerates. Now, consumer finance companies. We have also commercial finance companies. We have trade credit. Credit trading is such that an individual that goes to buy can be given a waiver, could be given time to pay back, or could, as a result of the volume of goods and goods collected, then there could be a trade discount. So such a thing can also help a private individual. And in insurance companies also assist, and a private source that capital can be assessed. Factor companies and leasing companies. Then we'll talk about types of debt financing available to small businesses, which include private placement of bonds, convertible debentures, industrial development bonds, leverage, buyout, and regular loans. These are some of the sources that are available to small businesses that most times that don't have access to getting loan from big banks, from the banks. So some of these middle ways can also help the SMEs, small and middle enterprise, to get their funds to run their businesses. Now we'll talk about classification of loans. We have long term, which maturity loan is longer than 1 year, while short term is shorter than 2 years of credit. Then we have also credit line for more immediate borrowing needs, because the credit line is such that an individual that is in business could approach bodies like the microfinance banks that can allow an individual to assess some loans for a short period and return as at when due. Then we also have a talk about public sources. This time we'll talk about private, we'll talk about public sources now. Is another area of assisting investors. Sometimes government will come up and provide loan, like we talk about agricultural loan, factor loan, and even housing loan. These loan lines are prevalent even in our country today, and this could be endorsed, because you must have someone to sign for you if you are going for such loans. So this could be endorsed by co-signers are guaranteed by the government. Central Bank of Nigeria sometimes floats some loans, and they will underwrite for some of the SMEs and SMIs. Then we'll talk about guaranteed by government. It's government now that guarantees such loans. And it's also secured, some of these loans are secured by collateral. The collateral could be through real estate, accounts receivable, inventory savings, life insurance, stocks and bonds or item purchased with the loan. What we mean by real estate is that when one is collecting a loan, it is expedient that there should be assurance that he's going to return the loan. That's why sometimes the bank would want to get either a house or a larger property to assist it in order to recover his loan if there's any default at any moment. Then we'll talk about inventory and savings. It could be a company's inventory could be assessed to know what is in the store, could pay back the loan, or how viable that company is. And we'll talk about savings. In when reports are published, companies publish their reports, the individuals or shareholders would like to know what is the level of savings in this bank, what is the rate of their cash flow, so that the individuals or the investors will be well assured that their money, their investments, will not just disappear as a result of bad management. Now we'll also talk about stocks and bonds. From time to time, governments try to flow some of these bonds, and it is a way of assisting investors in the system, so that whatever that is happening there, they will be able to recover. The investors will be well assured that the government will not leave them just uncared for. Then we'll talk about equity capital. This is secured from variety of sources. Equity capital, some sources of equity financing include entrepreneurs, friends, and family. Also include private investors, family, physician, as we can see from our material, family, physician, local business owners, wealthy entrepreneurs known as angels that are ready to finance some investment or some production line or some businesses. They will also talk about employees. We'll talk about customers and suppliers. Customers, suppliers, former employees, venture capital firms, investment banking firms, insurance companies, and large corporations, government-backed small business investment. All these are part of equity that could be, all these are sources to equity can be assessed by a company. Two primary methods equity can be financed. We'll talk about private placement of stock with investors or venture capital firms. Private investment, that is IPO, from time to time, companies try to look at their investment and say, okay, they have to flow some more shares. And they can also sell to already investors in that company. Then, say it is simpler, more common for young companies or startups, because when a company is starting, from time to time, we also hear of how they try to make sure that they are not stopped by lack of funding. So, even if they needed maybe some amount, and they go to stock market, and a company may start to take it up and pay them while it now sells the shares to the public. This is one of the ways of making sure that such companies that are just startups will not be left in a limbo because of lack of funding. And then we talk about public stock offerings. That is one of the areas of also getting capital for business. Public stock offerings, we know that they are lengthy and expensive registration process. That is some of the things that that are endemic in public stock offerings, which cannot be accommodated by SMEs and SMIs. But big conglomerates, big companies can easily assess, can go through such hurdles and still come out healthy. But we are looking at here what are involved as a result of going to assess this capital. So it is lengthy, it is expensive, it is also, it is a better option for mature companies, as I said, than for startups. And it is also public stock offerings offer strategic advantages in firms in terms of maintaining. Public stock is in terms of maintaining. That is, if the big companies try to go for the public offering, it is not a startup. It is not just starting its business today. But if a startup firm wants to go through that line, it may be stuck because of the processes that it has to continue. So we now look from all these avenues. Any business that wants to start, we have seen that they need, every business needs capital, whether it is a sole proprietorship or a public enterprise or even a government establishment. Because we also know that sometimes government run some commercial enterprises. But each one needs capital base. And all the sources we have mentioned are some of the areas that any company, any startup can access its capital. And those that are already existing can also boost their base, the base of their finance through these sources. Thank you very much.